Tohiju. This is Fierce Truth Seeker of the Red Road East. And we're out here at the African American Day Parade. And we have, representing the natives, two very special individuals. Hi, ladies.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. So what's going on today?
Osio, the Wadawa Usai Mohali. Hello, my name is Night Eagle from the Cherokee Language and Cultural Circle. And we are out here today with the American Day Parade to represent our Native American culture, to let everyone know that Native Americans are alive and well. And every year we try to come out to march and represent for our Native American people. It is our honor to show our ancestry. Donada, which means until we meet again.
Beautiful. And who do we have here?
Hello, I'm the Crazy Horse.
You might have to speak up a little bit because we got a lot of background noise.
Hello, I'm Kandia Crazy Horse. I'm here working with the Chala Youth Circle and my other relations in the African American Day Parade. Again, just to raise awareness about our presence in this community. I've also been engaged in the Dakota Access Pipeline resistance, and I'm here today to also spread the word about that since I'm doing an upcoming benefit here in Manhattan.
Beautiful. All right. Yeah, so I thank you ladies for allowing me to interview you. We'll be speaking again as the parade progresses. All right. How's it going?
Hey, doing all right, having fun. African American parade.
Yeah. It actually hasn't started yet, but this is your first time?
Yeah, the very first time, man, and the energy's great. To the young people dancing, I can't wait to start dancing and hearing that drum.
Yeah, so I'll definitely be taping you later on, you know, getting your dance moves on,
That's great, man.
Yeah.
That's great.
Definitely.
Great. Harlem, USA in 2016. What better place to be is right here, man.
Yeah.
Getting ready.
Definitely.
Taino strong, Taino peace.
That's right. Now let me take a look at your regalia here. You look like a real warrior, man. You look like you're ready to go to war.
I was gonna bring my war club, but I got my rattle. Peace warrior.
All right, Louis. So right, we will come back later on right. When the parade starts.
Thank you.
Okay.
Can I get you?
Sure.
Hey!
Mohawk flag there.
Yes, intertribal. Beautiful. Many nations, one tribe.
Beautiful.
In solidarity.
What else do we have here?
We have the Cherokee flag from Oklahoma. This is the official Cherokee flag.
Someone might ask, well, this is the African American Day Parade. Why are the Indians out here?
Because we want to show that even though this is the African American Day Parade, we have ties because we are Cherokee. And many of the people out here identify with their Native American roots.
Thank you.
No problem.
Peace. Right. Fierce Truth Seeker of the Red Road East, and we're at the end of our tour at the African American Day Parade. And before everybody gets too lax, I just want to get a few words from everybody about their experiences for the day.
OCL, this day has been a blessing. What a good feeling when we were marching in the parade to have the people respond to us with cheers and waves and smiles, saying, I'm Cherokee, I'm Native. It's a good feeling to be in this parade every year and show our Native culture. And it's a good feeling to get a response from the crowd. Yes, my feet hurt, my back is hurting, but I feel good. Thank you so much for documenting this tremendous event, and hopefully we'll see you all next year. Donadab.
You're quite welcome. Well, I'm not going to let you go quite yet now. Now, how do you feel about the turnout? Were you satisfied with the amount of Natives that came out, or do you desire for more participation, or give me some thoughts about that?
Well, absolutely. I think I'm going to turn this over to my sister Eagle Woman, and she's going to tell you how she feels about the turnout.
Okay. Eagle Woman. Now, tell me about your experience here at African American Day Parade today and the response you got from the crowd, and also the turnout for the Native representation. Were you satisfied, or would you desire to see more Native American representation next year? Or tell me a little bit about your experience.
Well, I enjoyed the parade this year. I enjoyed the response from the spectators. I especially want to thank the people who did come out to participate with us, but I have to say that I am disappointed, and I become more and more disappointed every year, because every year I tell people about this function and tell them how important it is that we show up in numbers, because we can't accomplish anything if we don't have numbers. All right, we don't need a lot of money, but we do need a lot of people to represent who we are, to let people know we're here and we have a purpose. And no one's going to know that if they only see one or two people. So it's very important that when we have things like this, you participate. We do powwows and everybody's there. But when we do something that's going to benefit our community, we have very few people. So I'm asking and I'm begging practically. For the next event, if we ask you to come, could you please, please, it's not just for us, it's for the future generations. This generation is almost gone. We need to prepare for the next generation and the generation after that. So please, when we ask you to participate, do the best that you can. And don't tell us you're going to come if you're not. And that's the way I feel.
Mm.
And thank you.
Wow. That was some serious chastisement there, people. So, you know, next year, y'all got to do a lot better. A lot better, or else Eagle Woman's going to come with that claw and she's like...
Honey, I'm with the vultures. Never mind the eagle. We're going to get you. But I'm serious. It's important that we all stick together. I mean, we have a handful of people that we know we can depend on when it comes to serving our people. But then the first time something happens, everybody's all up in arms. But it's all mouth, and you're not doing anything to try to further yourself.
Mm.
You know? We need to be out there in the forefront. Let them know, hey, this is who we are. And don't look for those stereotypical TV and movie characters, because that's not who we are.
Exactly.
Everybody that you've seen today in this parade, that's who we are. We come in every shape and color.
That's right.
Don't look for the long, straight hair. Don't look for the light skin, because we are all of it.
All shades.
So.
All descriptions.
That's right. And we love each other.
That's right.
A cherry Pepsi would be great.
Excuse me.
A cherry Pepsi, huh?
Are you filming now?
Yeah.
The audience and my relations that I marched with today, I was happy to represent the Pamunkeys in the African American Day Parade. This may be a first, I don't know. But also...
Oh, this is your first one?
This is my first one.
Wow.
Marching. Yes, I am resident of High Harlem, so I'm glad to turn out today. I was also here to represent those of us that are engaged with the Dakota Access Pipeline resistance. That has been a major thing that I've been involved with over the past 2 months. I've written a song for the water protectors in Standing Rock, even though we are in the Northeast, far away. As we've seen this week, the oil disasters are reaching here. Where I'm from, in the Southeast, we have a state of emergency in Alabama, Georgia, and so on. trying to put a pipeline in my home state of Virginia. So, you know, this fight is not just the Native fight, and it's not just something that's happening out west, remote, only focused on the Missouri River and its tributaries. It is coming our way, and we all need to be prepared and pitching and do what we can.
Sounds good. All right, well, Candia, thank you very much.
Thanks for
the interview.
Thanks for marching with you. We were
likewise.
Doing all the steps.
Yeah.
I think we held our own, even though we had the marching band coming up behind us.
Yeah.
We're not FAMU, and we didn't have the marching 100, but we did our best.
Sure did.
I think people are aware that we're still here, and there are natives in New York.
That's
quiet
right.
As it's kept. So.
Yep.
Donada.
Donada. All right. Yeah, now we're back with Circle Chief, Tall Eagle. Yeah, so tell me, how was your experience today marching in the African American Day Parade representing the Native Americans?
I enjoy this every year. I've been marching for 4 years.
Okay.
And the response is tremendous. It's a wonderful response to get back. We are few when we march, but we get applause and yays and woo-hoo. You know, but it makes me feel good to know that I can be a part of this parade,
mm-hmm.
You know, to represent and ensure that we Native Americans are here. We are not just here, we're everywhere. So this gives us a chance to shine, and shine we do.
Yeah. Do you hope to have more people, more Natives come out in support next year?
Well, I hope so. But, you know, doing it, there's powwows that are on the same weekend as parade, but I'm grateful for who comes.
Okay.
I mean, it could be one or two, but it's still March.
Yeah.
And like I said, we get a good response from the crowd.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I enjoy that more than anything else.
Okay.
Other than representing who we are.
Yeah.
Native Americans.
Beautiful. All right. Thanks for the good words and allowing us to record you today. And we'll be talking soon.
All right. Donada.
Donada. And now we're back with my main man, Luis Ramos.
What's up, bro?
And all right. So tell me, this is your first experience at the African American Day Parade, and tell me what the experience was like representing the Natives.
Well, you know, I've danced like 8 years in a row in a Puerto Rican parade.
Okay.
And I felt the same spirit, you know.
Wow.
When people look in your eyes and they see you dance, you can see they try to dance, and they, you know, we make a connection.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see how they, you know, we become one. And that's that whole DNA, that's that whole spirit, that's that whole, you know, we're one family, one people.
Yep.
It doesn't matter about color.
That's right.
But it matters that we're one people. And it was amazing today, man. I felt that. And, and no matter how tired I got, once you connect with people, look in their eyes, they make you dance, you know?
That's right.
And that's why I couldn't stop dancing. You know?
Yeah, you feed off of that energy that they give you.
Yeah, man. It's
yeah.
Like family.
Oh, yeah.
Yup. Something. I was impressed today with the men. You know, the men, African American men, they were really like feeling it. I was playing the rattle, and they wanted me to play more. So that was amazing. Seeing the men.
Yeah.
Requesting that music. Blessings, you know?
Oh, yeah.
That was great.
Wow.
Yeah.
So
I can't wait till next year, man.
Definitely. And this is not the last time you're going to be with us at the Red Road East, you know?
Definitely, man. You know, we're going to set it up for next year, you know?
No doubt,
and
no doubt.
Come before that, representing African-American, Black Indians, Taino, you name it, we're all one people.
That's it.
We're all brown.
That's it.
White, whatever.
Yep.
We're still one people.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Definitely. All right, well, I'll let you get back into your food there. And we will see you soon.
All right, thank you.
Okay.
Peace out. Taino peace.
All right. Donada. This is Fierce Truth Seeker from the Red Road East. And I have
Mashantucket
family here. So Tell me, how was your experience today at the African American Day Parade?
I had a great time. I actually got to see some people I haven't seen since 1978.
Wow.
So I was very happy to be here at the parade, and I kept thinking, oh, it's gonna rain, but I took my chances and came out anyway.
What's your name?
My name is Toni Parker Johnson. I'm an elder with the Mashantucket Pequot Tribal Nation.
Oh, wow. Yeah. And what
I'm
is your name,
elder,
young
I'm a John
man?
John Jones.
John Jones?
And I'm not an elder. I'm a
I hear
bud.
That.
That's
right.
On the
horse.
One of the wild ones.
I used to go to Skamitson all the time. It was like really, really big. I haven't been since y'all started having it on the reservation. So I'm going to make it my business to come out there next year.
It's smaller and more intimate, but it's still a good time.
I like that, though.
It's still a good time, and it's going back to the way it used to be.
I like that better, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everybody that knows is Cherokee. You don't say no more as far as mixture.
Yeah.
You pull out the Native American.
Yeah, there's so many different nations.
Yeah,
here.
But you don't mix it with the other half. Yeah. And call them out.
Yeah.
You know, the most of us is the melting pot.
Right, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But when you say it, it's Cherokee Creek. The other I leave out. I'm going to be like, come.
He leaves, leaves the nut part out, too.
Let me get the shirts.
I know.
This is the Jummy People Crew I used to march in 1968.
Wow.
From 1965 to 1968.
Okay.
Best years of my life. And I was in the color guard. I spun the flag and everything. And
yeah.
Miss those days.
Wow. Huh? And let me get that t-shirt. That's a beautiful t-shirt. Yeah, let me zoom in on that.
Sorry, I ran my foundry and father.
Oh, yeah. Skamitson.
I try to pass it on. That's all you can do.
That's it.
The young ones are hard to pick it up.
You're right about that.
The devil's work is out here. Cell phones. You don't go by tails no more.
That's good. That's
they don't know none of the tails.
Like, I remember these parades, me and some of my girls from the Jimmy Bureau were talking about it today.
They don't listen.
So many hands. There were no breaks.
So you're supposed to know your bloodline.
That's right.
You know who you are, where
everything
you came from. You know somewhere where you're going.
Yes, that's right. That's it.
It's a big universe.
Now, when people see that, they go like, hey, get out.
See, yep. Father in heaven, that's what they mean. Father in heaven. There's no end to heaven. We here for a blank, but that's it.
Just got to keep the stories on.
That's right. That's right. Still got to get together.
Yeah.
That's what they mean when you have meals together and break
and
bread together.
Young people see this and they think that's
got to do it.
That's right. That's right.
You can't always do it. You got to do it once a month, once every other month. Just do it.
I was born and raised in New York.
What is your position in the nation?
I'm independent.
Okay.
All the way.
Okay.
All I know is my DNA, and that's it.
I hear
that. I got
that
from my elder.
Thank you for allowing us to videotape you.